Division of segments and angles, level 7. In this video, we will go over slightly more challenging examples involving angle bisectors and angle trisectors. Let's take a look at the first example. Given that the measurement of angle FGJ is equal to 3x minus 5, the measurement of angle JGH is equal to x plus 27, and ray GJ bisects angle FGH. Find the measurement of angle FGJ. In this problem, we are provided with a diagram, along with algebraic expressions representing the measurement of two angles. We are also given that a ray bisects an angle. We are asked to find the measurement of a particular angle. Let's start by marking the diagram with the given information. We know that the measurement of angle FGJ is equal to 3x minus 5, and that the measurement of angle JGH is equal to x plus 27. We also know that ray GJ bisects angle FGH. So let's draw single arc marks for angle FGJ and angle JGH, since they are congruent. Now that we have the given information labeled in the diagram, let's go ahead and plan how we are going to solve for x. We know that angle FGJ and angle JGH are congruent. We also have an algebraic expression representing the measurement of both of these angles in terms of x. So let's go ahead and set both of these algebraic expressions equal to each other. Now we can solve for x. So we first subtract x from both sides of the equation. We then add 5 to both sides of the equation. Finally, we divide both sides of the equation by 2 and simplify. Doing that, we obtain x equals 16. The last step is to use this value of x and substitute it into the algebraic expression representing the measurement of angle FGJ. Doing that and simplifying, we obtain 43 degrees for the final answer. Alright, let's take a look at the next example. Given that angle ABC is equal to 90 degrees, angle 1 is equal to 2x plus 10, angle 2 is equal to x plus 20, and angle 3 is equal to 3x, determine if angle ABC has been trisected. In this problem, we are provided with a diagram and the measurement of three distinct angles. We are asked to determine if a particular angle has been trisected. In order to determine if angle ABC has been trisected, we need to show that angle 1, angle 2, and angle 3 are congruent. Before we do that, we need to figure out the value of x so that we can use it to determine the measurement of each angle. Notice that angle ABC is a right angle, since it measures 90 degrees. So we can label angle ABC with a small square mark. We also know from the diagram that angle ABC is formed by angle 1, angle 2, and angle 3. This allows us to set up the following geometric relation. The measurement of angle 1 plus the measurement of angle 2 plus the measurement of angle 3 is equal to the measurement of angle ABC. With this geometric relation, we can go ahead and substitute the algebraic and numerical expressions for each angle. Doing that, we obtain the following equation. From here, we can solve for x. Let's first collect like terms. Then, we subtract 30 from both sides of the equation. We then divide both sides of the equation by 6. Simplifying the expressions, we obtain 10 for the value of x. Now that we know the value of x, we go ahead and substitute it into the algebraic expressions of angle 1, angle 2, and angle 3. Simplifying the expression for each angle, we obtain 30 for all three angle measurements. Since all three angles are congruent, we can conclude that angle ABC has been trisected, and this is our final answer. Let's end the video with a final example. Ray OG and ray OH divide straight angle FOJ into three angles whose measures are in the ratio 4 to 3 to 2. Find the measurement of angle FOG. In this problem, we are provided with a diagram of a straight angle that is divided into three smaller angles. We are asked to find the measurement of one of these smaller angles. In order to figure this out, we need to determine the value of x, so that we can substitute it into the algebraic expression of angle FOG. We can figure out the value of x by setting up an equation using a relevant geometric relation. We know that angle FOJ is a straight angle. This means that it measures 180 degrees. We also know that angle FOJ is divided into three smaller angles, so we can set up the following geometric relation. The measurement of angle FOG plus the measurement of angle GOH plus the measurement of angle HOJ is equal to the measurement of angle FOJ. Notice that we are given an algebraic expression for the measurement of the smaller angles. These measurements are in the ratio of 4 to 3 to 2. We also know that the measurement of angle FOJ is equal to 180 degrees, since it is a straight angle. With this equation, we can now solve for x. So we collect like terms and divide both sides of the equation by 9. Simplifying the expression, we obtain 20 for the value of x. Now that we know the value of x, we can go ahead and substitute it into the algebraic expression representing the measurement of angle FOG. Simplifying the expression, we obtain 80 degrees as the final answer. Alright, in our final video on this series, we're going to go over two challenging examples involving angle bisectors and angle trisectors.